Okay, so for creating your title, if you look at the artist's work, you will see that she uses lovely greeny, bluey tones. We've got light blues, dark blues, different tones of blue. So all I've done is chosen colour pencils that I think match up with the tones that she uses within her work. So here's my title. You can choose to use all of the colours, or you could just choose a small selection. For example, you might just want to use purple, dark blue, light blue, or dark blue, light blue, green. That is totally up to you which colours you want to use. I am going to use these four colours. So we are working from dark to light. You might just choose one colour. You might choose to go from dark and then light towards the bottom of the letter. That is up to you, and you can judge what your ability is. The more colours you use, the more able you are. So I'm going to put them in order from darkest to lightest, which is this order. And then all I'm going to do, I'm going to start off on my first letter. I'm going to start off with my darkest colour or tone. Your shading should always follow, and I'll just zoom in, it should always follow the outline of the shape. So at the top up here, I'm just going to follow the outline and I'm going to curve around. So what I'm going to do is go from dark to light. I'm going to start to fade that purple away now. And then it's fading, it's fading, it's gone. I'm going to pop that colour down. I'm going to select my next darkest colour. And where that purple starts to fade is where I'm going to start dark with my next colour. So I'm starting here, and then I'm going to work my way down and fade that blue out. You can go back to that purpley colour and just push it into the blue. Just to get an even better blend. There we go. So I'm going to fade that blue a little bit more. And then I can start with the next colour, which is the light blue. So where the dark blue starts to fade is where my light blue is going to go in. And then I'm going to start to fade that light blue. And bring the green in. And there we've got a nice blend from purple through to blue through to the green. So then I'd start again on my next letter doing exactly the same. So you are following the outline of the shape. So because the outline flows in this direction, that's the direction that my shading will flow in. Just following the outline. just to do my last minute finishing touches, what I am going to do, once I've completed every single letter using that blending technique with the colour pencils, then what I'm going to do is just outline it with black. And I quite like that. What you could do, as she's a stitch artist, and I'm using a biro pen for this, what you could do around the letter is just give the impression that it's been stitched on. Which is quite nice. So you can just carry on with your title doing the exact same techniques, the colour pencil with the blending, the outline with a fine liner or the felt pen, and then the biro for the stitching. So you were following the outline of the shape.